Hello, and welcome to Bishop Carroll TV. I'm Cameron Villa.
And I'm Curtis Light.
This week, in honor of the release of Star Wars, we have Jake Campbell and John Suffield reviewing the latest blockbuster hits.
Hello, and welcome to the first edition of BCTV Movie Reviews. If you thought we ran out of ideas last time, then oh boy, you haven't seen anything yet because we are reviewing movies now. That being said, Thor Ragnarok came out November 3rd, and boy, was it well worth the wait.
I didn't like it.
Oh really? Why was that, John?
Well, it made the somewhat serious parts into a comedy, and well, Winter Soldier was better.
Well, while I respectfully disagree, I do admit that the comedy fell flat in some areas, but it more than made up for it with its stellar wit.
I recognize your choice to disagree, but given that it is a horrible choice, I have elected to ignore it.
Are we really going to go there, John?
You started it.
We give Thor Ragnarok 4.25 Mjolnirs out of 5 Mjolnirs. Next, we have Coco. Truly amazing. The art, the emotion, the appeal.
I didn't like it.
You didn't like it now?
Too colorful. It hurt my eyes. It was also made by Pixar.
All right, fine. You didn't like it. I get it. In my opinion, Pixar is great, and so is Coco.
Whatever.
All right. We give Coco 8 Spanish guitars out of 10 Spanish guitars. Next, we have...
something I am truly excited for! Star Wars The Last Jedi! Since it hasn't came out yet, we're gonna review the trailer. This trailer gave me chills. I am so excited to finally see Mark Hamill's Luke Skywalker after all these years!
Why don't you pump your brakes there, John? I don't know about that. The trailer looked a tad cliche, you know? They might just redo Empire Strikes Back. They might not have learned their lesson from The Force Awakens.
But this is a totally different movie. The Last Jedi is directed by completely different people, and I'm looking forward to it, as I'm sure many of the viewers are as well.
But considering the trailer was a bit meh, we give the new Star Wars trailer 3.5 Stormtroopers out of 5 Death Stars.
We'll agree to disagree. Back to you guys.
Thanks, guys. The Cannes Food Drive officially wrapped up on the 27th as communities tore down their sculptures and donated the cans.
Over 22,000 cans were donated, with St. Teresa of Calcutta as the highest-raising community, and St. Teresa of Lisieux won the sculpture contest with their cheeseburger meal. Good work, everyone.
Now we have Kayla Teeter telling you what's in the news.
In the political realm, when North Korea tested an intercontinental ballistic missile last Tuesday, analysis quickly determined that the weapon would be able to reach any target in the continental United States. Further photo and video analysis since indicated that the missile test represents even greater advance in capabilities than analysis first thought. More North Korea missile advancements means more tough questions for the country's enemies. President Trump and GOP House Speaker Paul Ryan won a majority victory as the House passed a new GOP tax bill last Thursday. The legislation would affect every American household and business owner. The bill was first introduced on November 2nd and was voted on just 2 weeks later, leaving little time for analysis or debate on the 440-page legislation. College football has finished the regular season. Number 1 Clemson and number 4 Alabama are set to play in the All-State Sugar Bowl on January 1st. Number 2 Oklahoma and number 3 Georgia will play in the Rose Bowl on January 1st. The winners of the Sugar and Rose Bowls will play in the CFP National Championship on January 8th. That's it for current events. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Kayla. As the fall sports season wraps up, let's go to our very own Jacob Carlo with a debut of the winter sports season, followed by a highlight of the fall sports.
Wrestling participated in the Valley Center Invitational last Saturday. Carson Dugan took third, Matt Gottschalk took fourth, and Colton Innes took fifth. Trap shooting is currently ranked second in 5A. Rebecca Ring ranked second overall for females. Girls basketball beat North last Friday, while the boys fell short. Both teams played yesterday at Heights. Good luck to our winter sports as they start the season. Now here's a highlight of our fall sports.
Telling everybody up your speed. That was a couple of years ago. And now I'm revving up for that ever and switching up gears. Got a couple of years to go. Here we go. Soon as you hear that go. Liverpool to Portsmouth. Yeah, that chorus. Got the crowd screaming.
seatbelt, Derek's back. Time to blow like I'm dynamo. No more disappearing act. I know you missed me, I missed you too. Sometimes that's what a miss will do. Like Tayo, I was cruising. Now it's time to take my steering back. One of the best to ever do it. A testament to this gang. And even in the wind, I never blew it. I swear but kept to my name. They call me Fleetwood Mac. I'm a Mac with a fleet. Still getting royalties. No spoiler, but I swear you me. I got you crowd screaming.
Great job to the fall sports teams. Let's keep that momentum going strong.
We decided to kick off the winter sports season by sending two of our best swimmers, Matthew Kelly and Patrick Cook, to join the swim and dive team.
All right, welcome back to Day in the Life. I'm Matthew Kelly.
And I'm Patrick Cook.
And we're here with Logan, who's been diving for 3 years now.
3 years.
And he's going to give us some tips to be successful in diving. So what are some of the key tips that we need to know?
So tip number one would be consistency. You're not going to be good in your first practice. That's just how it is. So you got to stay with it. You got to just keep trying, and eventually you'll get better. Second tip is don't be afraid of the water. Don't be afraid of the board. That's pretty much the main issue for all new divers. They're just scared that they're going to hit the board. And what was my third tip?
All right. That's it. All right, so let's head to the first dive. What do you got planned for us?
First dive is just simple, easy, board, 1.5.
Good job.
So
what's
close.
The second dive?
Second dive is going to be a reverse dive in the tuck position. Next dive is gonna be a back 1.5 with a half twist. Last dive is gonna be a forward 2.5 in the tuck position. So your face and back hurts,
yeah.
And just your back hurts, yeah. Right? So how do you guys like diving so far?
It's a lot harder than you think. I mean, you guys go through a lot.
Yeah.
You know, I thought I did pretty good.
Yeah, you did pretty good, Patrick.
I think you did do pretty good. Definitely for your first time.
Yeah, cool. Thank you for this.
No problem.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll come back next year and see how we'll do then.
All right.
Back to you guys.
Wow, that was pretty impressive, wouldn't you say, Cam?
I thought it went swimmingly. This ends our broadcast. May the force be with you all.
That's not how the force works, but we'll go announcements anyways.